Hey guys, Chris Trump here. I started a YouTube channel and wanted to share with you guys everything I do and learned, and I'm not gonna explain natural farming today or teach you how to natural farm. For you today, I just start out by showing you guys how I do IMO3 here in my lab in the warehouse where I farm from. So here we are, we're in the lab, I'll show you around, but real quick, let me show you how I do IMO3. First off, I know exactly what I'm using, and I know I've done it 100 times, so I know the amounts I need, I know how it all goes. So what I've done is I've just put up a cheat sheet, created a cheat sheet for myself and my coworkers, if someone else needs to make it, where I don't have to figure out or check really too much for moisture. I know if I use 10 gallons by volume of my material, then all I need is that much liquid. So, here we are. Got my liquid, got my material, got my trusty HDPE cement mixer, and I am going to mix it all together. So first off, I got my material. I use material from my industry, my farm. It's a byproduct, a waste product, so to speak, of kernel and shell for macadamia nuts. I grow macadamia nuts. So I got my carbohydrate and my carbon. Next, here I got about a gallon and a quarter of water, and I need to add my inputs to it. So first, I'm gonna add my seawater, about 5-6 ounces. I'm gonna add a tiny bit extra. Seawater goes in. Next, I'm gonna add my FPJ, about 0.3 ounces. So just a little bit. Brown rice vinegar. OHN, my OHN is over 3 years old, so it only adds 0.1 ounces, it's really effective. Tiny bit there. I use humic acid because I want to maximize the fungal growth. So humic acid goes in. I use 0.6 here. So I'm doubling up. I'm going to use 0.5. Okay, now we're ready for our IMO2. So I'm gonna scoop a little liquid and let's go check out our IMO2. So here we are at my IMO2 collections. They're beauties. So this is the strength of natural farming and really why I think we're able to produce a good product that our trees love. Is a bunch of collections and a bunch of diversity. So I have kind of ohia grows way up on the mountain, kind of undisturbed. I have upper macadamia nut areas. I have older macadamia nut areas. This is from almost 3 years ago. I have spring dry collections. And I'm gonna use all of it to make this IMO3. So what we're going to do is take a little bit from each one. I have real clean hands. I washed them right before I did this. I'm going to take just a tiny bit from each collection here. The lid back on temporarily. I use a different finger for each one. I don't want to add one collection's biology to the other. I want to keep them unique. I will be adding a ton more videos on how to do all this. If you aren't somebody that naturally farms, bear with me. Just check it out and enjoy. And I'll explain how to do the whole process. Today is just kind of for the natural farmers and to introduce what I do here. I love it. And it works. So these are pretty fresh collections, this one right here. This is just from 20 days ago. And that's it, just about a quarter size from each one. I'll come back and secure these lids. Let me wash my hands and we'll move back over. All right, here I am with my IMO2 in a little bit of liquid. I put it in a little bit of liquid so that I can thoroughly stir it. Kind of like if you're eating at the sushi restaurant, you put a little wasabi, or plenty of wasabi in, a little shoyu so that you can get it all mixed and then you add shoyu paste. Same idea. Then you're not dealing with a bunch of floating chunks. So I get it nice and stirred. You can even take this and throw it straight on here, just in case you don't use all of that, so that you get all your inoculum, even if you don't use all your ingredients. But I'm just gonna throw it in here. I'm gonna use almost all of this. I'm very positive. So I've done it before. All right, now comes the hard part. No, it's the easy part. We have a cement mixer. I take my liquid, splash it in. And there it goes. Then I turn it off and I get right to the back to make sure there's no spots that aren't mixed. Scoop it all out. I'm gonna get it even. And then got my sticker up here, so I just flip it over one time. A little bit more. Sticker over there. I get in here to the area I haven't got yet. Okay, it feels nice and evenly mixed. I like the moisture, but I'm going to add a little bit more. Alright, I like the moisture. Macadamia nuts have lots of oils, so we don't get too moist. Alright, now that my IMO is all nicely mixed, I come over here with my, yes, this is my brood bin. So my IMO 3 is going to process within a cedar box that I made for this purpose. Come check out the cedar box. So this has gaps all around the edges and on the top and in the inside. So the microbes get to process in here with breathability. We don't jam them in here too full. And right here, we'll just pull this straight on in. Not only can you do this by yourself very easily, but you can do it with one hand while holding the camera and barely breaking a sweat on a super muggy day in Hawaii. We just had a hurricane or a tropical storm, and so it's been crazy muggy. That last scoop, and we're done with the cement mixer. We'll go rinse that out in a minute. Take our material, spread it out nice and evenly. The floor has gaps in it too, so this is nice and breathable area. A beautiful day to make IMO 3. So now, I'll shut the lid. Got a little material on the edge, don't want that. Shut the lid. And this is good to go. We'll turn it every day, super easy to turn. My nice straight shovel gets in there. We'll scoop it all to one side, back to the other side. Really easy. As soon as this is finished, in about a week, it'll run out of all its moisture and will be finished, and we'll transfer it to our storage cedar box. This one has no gaps, super tight. You can barely see where one board begins and another ends. I oiled the top so we don't get any moisture or water falling in. And this is where our IMO 3 is kept, ready for use for making liquid IMO and spraying on our trees. Check that out. Super, super yummy. And then this goes into this big old tank. Full of all kinds of aeration and all the good nutrients for making liquid IMO. The IMO is down there in these stainless steel baskets, and it's brewing. And that, after 36 hours,
via this 2-inch hose, gets pumped out to our Venturi air sprayer and gets sprayed on the trees every single week at about this time of day as the sun's going down in beautiful Kohalane. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you soon. Check out this channel. I'm gonna post all kinds of fun stuff about natural farming, how I do it on a large scale, and I just wanna share. I'm grateful for what I've got and been able to learn, and I really want to make sure that anybody that wants to can have tons of success in this. So, see you guys soon. Have a great day. Aloha.